Hey guys, how's everything going this evening? I'm doing all right. I just wanted to put a video out there. This video is also going towards Instagram and Facebook. I wanted to put it out there that there are a lot of people probably going through a lot of tough times right now, either with bullying or racism or what have you. Anyways. All you guys need to stay strong, be there, give real support, and be loving and caring to other people. Even if they're not loving and caring to you, always be the right person. If somebody tells you you can't do it with something that you want to do, you go and prove them wrong because you could do it. You could do anything that your heart and your mind and your soul can do. If you put enough work into it and you want it as bad as you say you want it, go do it. Everybody used to tell me, oh, you can't live outside of a group home, which I was living in a group home for a while. And they also said I wasn't going to be able to get married and have a family. And if I moved out of a group home, I'd probably lose my place in 2 weeks or what have you. And I'd just go right back to a group home. Well, here's my point. I never had to go back to a group home. I haven't been to jail ever since 2003, 2004. I'm happily married. I have kids. I'm there for my kids as much as I possibly can be, especially my 4-year-old. His name is Presley, and he's autistic. I do what I possibly can. Okay, we lost our daughter Molly December 6th of 2018. Then we lost my dad March 7th of this year. All that's been hard, and I'm gonna try to tell you that. With losing a child, it never gets easier. I'm going to be quite honest and quite frank and blunt. That doesn't get easy. Anybody that tells you that losing a child and the way you feel and all that is going to get easier over time, it doesn't. It's been, I want to say, 2 years, I believe. Yeah, close to about 2 years since we lost her. And I still feel the same way I did before. Okay? Never, ever let your faith go. If you've got it in faith in Jesus Christ, keep it up. Because after we lost our daughter, I didn't know what to believe in. I mean, have faith in. I mean, don't get me wrong. I believed in God and Jesus Christ and all that other stuff. But I just didn't have faith in him anymore. And then my wife talked me into going to church with her, and we did. And one day after my dad passed away, which was my dad passed away March 7th, me and my wife got baptized on the day after that, the 8th of March. Okay, so nobody's perfect. Nobody is perfect. Love and care everybody about everybody. Support everybody that you possibly can. And just because people say you can't do this, you can't do that, you can, as long as you put your mind to it. And as far as people out there that are struggling with bullies and stuff, find other people to hang out with. And your life is more precious than that. I see it all the time with just death caused by suicide due to bullying. And that's sad. I had a friend that her son committed suicide at age 13. And I'm like, my heart broke. Let's see here. Excuse me, sorry. And then on top of that, women out there, you women out there that are getting abused sexually, physically, mentally, verbally, and emotionally, get out. You can deserve a heck of a lot better than that. Okay. The guy says, well, I love you, blah, 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 blah. And he lays a hand on you. He don't love you. How many times have I laid a hand on my wife since me and her got together? We argue all the time. And I have never once laid a hand on her. That is love. Okay, you don't use that kind of shit. Okay, this video might be begin to monetize because of my curse words. But men that do that are just assholes and pussies, okay? And then as far as the homeless goes, they're doing what they can. Don't take it that if they ask for money that they're going to use it for alcohol, because most of them ain't like that. I had a buddy of mine that was a millionaire and that lost everything, and including his wife. His kids were grown, but his wife left him because he was broke. Then the house went to foreclosure. He ended up homeless on the streets. He was helping people out left and right. And he asked for a couple of bucks about a month or two ago. And they told him no, because we're not going to support you on your alcohol assumption or something like that. And I'm like thinking to myself, just because they're homeless and down their luck doesn't mean that you think that they're drinking. Even if you do see it in a liquor bottle, that doesn't mean it's alcohol. They could have rinsed it out really good and put water in it or what have you. So never be that stupid not to help. Even if they are going and buying booze, you're helping them to get a drink. And stop being mean to them, because most of them help fight our country. And also, you guys that are abusing women out here, you guys are fucking pussies. The real fucking pussies. You're man enough to hit a woman, by guarantee. If I ever seen you do that in person, that'd be the last motherfucking thing you do. Just an FYI. But anyhow, my whole point of shooting this video was, of all the stuff going on right now, I believe in COVID, yes, but I only believe in it so far. Okay? And also, when it comes down to racism, grow the fuck up. Honestly, we are all brothers and sisters of God. And some of you were like, well, I'm atheist. I'm like, I don't care if you're atheist. If you're atheist, that means you at least believe in hell. And if you believe in hell, then that means you believe in heaven. And even if you didn't believe in any of those, you can't. My problem is that all I can say is it's not worth it. Go and do what is supposed to be right. And don't live up to other people's standards. Live up to your own. I love each and every one of you. I care about each and every one of you. And I think about each and every one of you every day. So if you guys ever need the talk or whatever, put down your phone number on the comments. I'll go through them on like a video or whatever. And I could probably give you a phone call. It might be restricted, but I can give whoever to call the help. I have no money. I'm broke anyways. But just to speak to somebody and understand, like, I've been through a lot in my entire life. So if anybody needs help physically, mentally, emotionally, or they need their hopes in God back, their faith back, I'll help. So if you guys leave your guys' phone numbers and the comments. I will call you guys and help you. And I'm not in there to scam anybody because I'm not asking for any money. That's not the kind of person my dad raised me to be. And he's dead now. So he's watching me while everything I'm doing. Which is kind of creepy if you think about it. But anyways, I'm going to let you guys go. Again, if you guys need any help whatsoever, feel free to contact me through any of my messages. Any of my comments. And I will put some links to my Instagram on here and go from there. All right, well, you guys all take it easy. God bless you all. And keep all your guys' heads up. And till my next video, peace, love you, and have a great night.